the U.S. Air Force is eyeing a wide range of possible non-traditional missions for the Boeing F-15EX Eagle II, its latest fighter aircraft. Those future missions could include operating the F-15EX as a command and control node, a platform for outsized weapons, and potentially as a key enabler in the service's concepts for manned-unmanned teaming. TWZ was on scene at Eglin AFB, the epicenter of F-15EX trials, to get a first-hand look at what USAF testers were doing to prep the Eagle II for all the additional capabilities it could potentially assume in the future. The first emphasis for the F-15EX combined test team at Eglin Air Force Base, Florida, was the initial fielding of the fighter, ensuring the new Eagle II is suitable and ready to replace aging F-15CS in Air National Guard units. The USAF is recapitalizing single-seat F-15C squadrons as a primary objective, so initial suitability evaluation of the EX was mainly geared towards that direct replacement, said Major Aaron Kamikaze Eshkenazi, an F-15EX pilot assigned to the 85th Test and Evaluation Squadron, TES, Skulls at Eglin Air Force Base. Initial evaluation of the F-15EX was completed in November 2023. That was with dedicated mission sets to prove that this airplane is ready to go into full-rate production. Those flights were intentionally flown solo because that's where the airplane is initially going, so we had to ensure we were not testing something that was not representative of what the CAF, Combat Air Force, or frontline squadrons, is going to be starting out doing. The F-15EX takes the best of both the F-15C and F-15E worlds and combines that with all the enhancements that have been added to the jet. So when we talk about the US Air Force of the future, we're actually pushing the F-15EX into that future as a brand new platform, says Lieutenant Colonel Matthew Juice Russell, the Director of Operations at the 85th TES. We are inserting the F-15EX into the existing Eagle community, but it's 30 years newer than our most modern F-15S, adds Russell. The tactics, techniques, and procedures, TTPs, that have been developed for the Strike Eagle easily transfer over to the EX, plus it has new technology to take it into the future. The two-seat F-15EX is an off-the-shelf version of Boeing's advanced F-15, and it comes as standard with a two-place cockpit. The F-15EX needs to be effective when flown in a single-pilot configuration to mirror the current operating model of ANG F-15C units. The potential of flying with a weapon systems operator, WSO, in the back seat is also being explored for a variety of possible uses and future mission sets. We have also flown with two aircrew on board, a pilot and a WSO, so we are not staying too narrow, not over-focused, on just flying the jet solo, because there is an unknown sight picture of where the Air Force might want to go, says Eshkenazi. So all of those unknown quantities test our perspective to ensure this airplane is ready for whatever the Air Force ultimately decides to do with it. We aren't tying multi-role to having a two-person crew. We are absolutely not saying that if you're flying the jet solo, you can't do multi-role missions. It's about leaving our options open and covering all of that off from a test perspective. The Eglin-based Combined Test Force has immersed the Eagle II in realistic large-scale exercises as part of its introduction into the USAF fighter community to help testers understand exactly what the F-15EX might be capable of doing and how it will be able to work alongside its brethren fighter aircraft. To illustrate how things run on the operational test side, literally 2 weeks after we received the second F-15EX from the Boeing factory, we took it to a large force employment at Exercise Northern Edge 2021 in Alaska, said Major Eshkenazi. We've been integrating it with the F-15C and the F-15E and also with F-22s and F-35s to make sure the airplane is ready to go as soon as it hits the combat air force. The F-15EX has flown on Exercise Black Flag at Nellis AFB, and this week we are flying our F-15E-S on Exercise Checkered Flag that's running at Tyndall Air Force Base, Florida. those squadrons are also flying on the Combat Archer Weapon System Evaluation Program, WSEP, so they are shooting missiles in the Gulf of Mexico ranges too, and we are integrating here too. We aren't firing any missiles on this WSEP, but we will be firing the F-15EX's internal 20mm cannon against air-to-air towed gunnery targets. The digital fly-by-wire system in the F-15EX is a big change over the F-15E in terms of increased weapons carrying capability, as it has opened up two additional weapon stations on the wings. For the majority of regimes of flight, you don't really notice a significant difference in the handling of the airplane, explains Major Eshkenazi. The main intent of the fly-by-wire is about carrying heavier stores on the airplane. In the F-15C and F-15E, you have a mechanical control system. On the EX you still move the control column in the same way, but now it transitions into a fully electric flight control system that has a similar feel to the other models of F-15.